I am so grateful that I have kept video record and written documentation of almost everything to do with the behavior of the neighbors. I'm sorry that I've had to go through so much with the landlords and the other neighbors in order to keep such diligent records again. But I'm so glad I have, because with them doing this restraining order thing and me applying for special accommodations, it shows how long I have been dealing with this stuff from Park Lane, and that I haven't gone to the courthouse because of my own anxieties and fears, that I've just been keeping record of everything. So I'm gonna have to thank them in court for the catalyst to get the ball rolling on me reporting everything. I hate it, but this is where I'm at. Whew. I'm still recovering a bit from surgery, so all of this, oh, whoops, I almost showed a areola. It's illegal with the nipple, but the areola is still legal federally. Anyhow, I'm still recovering. See, look how nicely that bruise is in the scar is healing. It started itching finally, which means it's healing, which is a beautiful thing. Excuse me. It was a ventral hernia caused by, excuse me, from when I was extremely obese. It was a ball, like a fat cyst. But because I hyperventilate when I have panic attacks, it was constantly pushing and pushing and pounding on the ventral wall, which is the muscle that protects the lower part. It's the upper abdomen, the upper abdominal muscles. It's these right here. You know what I mean. I don't need to show you, but the upper abdominal muscles. Anyway, it's those that protect the ribs, the lower rib cage, and the lower part of the lungs and the stomach. Anyhow, constantly pounding because the diaphragm moving up and down, up and down, up and down. So it kind of blew its way through when I was poisoned and had that semi-stroke thing and was constantly having to compensate from this side being paralyzed to using this side. And then the Kundalini yoga, because I had to learn to coordinate both sides together again. So I'm recovering from that, and was having to go to court with these people. Plus the fact that I am non-confrontational. I react to other people coming to me. I don't even interact with people outside of my home. I respond to people, like the automatic response when people say good morning and good morning. Well, I'm trying to retrain myself not to smile every time, because I'm not happy every time, and I don't want to pretend to be anymore, which I had to be from the time I was small, doing pageants and things like that. So I'm trying to unlearn what I know to be true. And it's one of the hardest things ever, because everything in my life is an unlearning right now. The racism from my family is a constant thing. I have to constantly remind myself that I'm part Native American. I'm more Native American than I am white. And that's a hard one, because then my whole family on my mother's side, aside from my mother, is welcome to America and now speak English. That kind of white people who are actually native. I don't understand. It's like being freaking Hitler and killing off Jews when he was half Jewish. My whole life is a bunch of hypocrites. I might as well just move into a soapbox. Live in a soapbox. That way, if I feel high on the horse, I can just stand upon it. And if I feel like caging myself in, I can just climb inside. Be like a turtle carrying my home around. People laugh like I'm kidding. My truth is funny to other people, my suffering. My tagline I learned from my abusive husband is, "You laugh like I'm kidding." But he'd say it with that sociopathic look. You laugh like you think I'm kidding. Or you laugh like you know I'm kidding. And I've learned to do it. I have borderline personality disorder. I can do it quite well. I can lie quite well. I can cut off my emotions quite well. But I don't like getting to that point, because when I get to that point, it eats at my soul. I've learned how to be authentic, and I'm learning how to be more and more authentic every day. So any kind of lying, anything that goes against my soul now, crushes me. I used to pray for the eyes of Christ, and I warn everybody, don't do that, because you'll get them. If you're really open and receptive, you'll get them. The thing about me, though, is I've always had them. I never had to pray for them. I've always been told I feel too much, I laugh too hard, I sing too loud. Imagine if I haven't tried to curb myself exactly how out of control I would be in histrionic and need to be in an asylum. Part of me is grateful it was whipped out of me, but part of me is horrible at it, because I always had to raise my kids, do as I say, not as I do, because I was trained and ingrained and it was beaten into me, and it's hard for me to unlearn it. Not an excuse to keep doing it, but still a reason. So I rambled off on this rant because I'm having PTSD going in and out of reliving all of the stuff with the neighbors and the violence with their dog coming into my apartment and snapping at my daughter's dog. And the confrontations from this woman who shoulder bumps me in the hallway, and when I called the police and say she threatened to kick my ass, they tell me no crime has been committed and to take it up with my landlords. Well, I have a mental illness, so taking it up with people is hard. And that mental illness is exacerbated by being poisoned. See, I used to be a very strong, independent woman. Ask people that knew me before 2015. Ask almost anybody that actually knew me. I was strong and independent. Whether they liked me or not, I was still strong and independent and very self-assured. I knew who I was. I didn't know what I wanted. I didn't know how to be a good parent. I was always looking to better myself. But I was very sure of who I was. My self-esteem has always been high because I know I'm worthwhile. The rest of the world just doesn't see me, and that's frustrating. My daughter, my Daryl Emily, is teaching me to voice who I am without fear. Well, that kind of scares me, because voicing who I am without fear, there's risks and fallout. Tact is never something I've learned, but I have learned how to shut up, smile, and look pretty. And I don't like that side of me. So I don't know why I needed to rant, but I had to vent somewhere, and I guess this was a good place, and I couldn't sit down in the studio, because when I sat in the studio, all I kept doing was thinking about this restraining order bullshit. Because I gotta get everything in chronological order, and you know, before 2015, ask my professors, I was a research hound. I would research stuff to the point that my OCD would get me, that I would throw away an entire quarter's worth of work and redo it in a week because I wasn't satisfied with any of it. And I'd even change the entire thesis. And I'd still manage to get a 4.0 or better. Now, I can barely remember things, and I get my dates flip-flopped. And when I want to say Clark County, because I lived in Cowlitz County for so long, I keep saying Cowlitz County. You want to know something? Never once in my history of living in San Luis Obispo County as a teenager did I ever once call that Cowlitz County. Never. Never got them flipped and confused. Okay. Lived in Santa Barbara County when my kids were small and we were homeless. Never got it confused. Lived in San Luis Obispo County around the same time period. Never got them flipped or confused. And they were right next door to each other. However, I keep getting Clark and Cowlitz confused. I don't know if it's because they start with a C, if they're so close together, or if because Clark is so close to my home county of Cowlitz. But something is going on with that. So I needed a break from what I was doing for court on Friday. And I'm hurting from my surgery. And I needed to vent, apparently, about personal stuff. So I don't know if I should put this in Park Lane Pathos, if I should put this in the noisy neighbors crap, or if I should just put this in my freaking video vlog on YouTube. All I know is I needed a minute to breathe, and it's been 10 minutes, and I need to upload this because I need the memory in order to keep track of things for court. Blessed be, since I'm not finding it right now, please pray for me strength and a little bit of pressure to get this done, because my panic keeps propulsing me elsewhere, and my ADD keeps distracting me, and my hyperactivity part keeps me up and moving, which probably isn't good for healing, since I'm not supposed to be doing strenuous activities. It's exacerbating. Peace, love, joy. Pray for me strength, and I will send you love. Blessed be.